As I look back on the days that's gone by, I can't help but to think, what would I have done different than I did at that time? And you know what conclusion I come to is? The conclusion I come to is I would have done it just like I did it. That was days of joy and happiness and sadness and madness. The normal way of life. And as I sit here reminiscing through my years, I can't help but to feel a little sad inside. Because those days are gone forever and ever and ever and ever and ever and ever.
Good evening, over on the World Wide Web. You're tuning to Soul Expressions right here at iLive Radio. Your host, DJ Sessions, for our regular Sunday session right here. Don't forget you can catch us on all the platforms over on TuneIn, iLive Changing Radio. You can download the iLive Radio app from the Google Play Store. Or you can go over to to.iliveradio.com. That's to.iliveradio.com. Listen to us in audio. And also over on the Facebook Live, the J iLive profile. So first of all, I'd like to say happy Mother's Day over in the UK, or in the US and Canada. The UK was the 22nd of March, but for happy Mother's Day to all the mothers. I celebrated Mother's Day today, very special day for very special people in our lives. And I'd like to extend a very happy first Mother's Day to my daughter, who gave birth to my first grandson, or Cornelius, last week. So very, very, very special first Mother's Day to my daughter. Very proud of you. This has been a very difficult week, I'm not going to lie. It's one of my good friends I've known for many, many years, Ty, passed away from COVID-related issues. You know, he got COVID about three or four weeks ago and was pretty seriously ill in the hospital in intensive care, and they let him out and they put him onto a ward, but he never fully recovered. Unfortunately, developed pneumonia and passed away. So it's been very hard for us as a community who've known Ty for many years. I mean, I've known Ty. I knew Ty from the days I was dancing, very early on in the fridge, and he was a dancer too. He did his thing, but we've always remained very, very close. And I was very fortunate to have spent some time with him when I was in the UK last year, because we hadn't seen each other for like nearly 10 years up to that point. Because the last time I saw him was at the Top of the World memorial that we have at Top of the World. It was a group of DJs that passed away in 2000. We did a memorial in London. That's the last time I saw him until I saw him last year. And I'd just like to thank him. I know he's looking down right now, for taking my son under his wing and introducing my son to a lot of the people I used to party with and dance with and DJ for, you know, to show a little bit of our story, of our history. So the last 30 minutes of this show, we're going to do a very special video tribute to Ty, interview that he did with Shat D from My Soul. So we're going to play that in the live stream over on Facebook Live for the last 30 minutes of the show as my tribute to him. I miss him dearly. You know, I'm still not fully wrapped my head around the fact that he's not here. But all the tributes, you know, from all the artists and, you know, the Roots, and Talib Kweli did a special for him, and like all the outpouring of love has been very heartwarming and very touching to watch. You know, and definitely impacted and moved me. So I didn't want to do a Thai show today. You know, I want to do that special tribute for him. And then this morning we got news that we lost a soul legend, another one. Little Richard died earlier this week, and then we found out this morning that we lost Betty Wright. Found that out on my WhatsApp this morning. So we're gonna do a very special tribute to Betty Wright. I'm gonna play some of her songs and some of my favorite songs from her later on inside the show. But it's all about good music and good vibes and trying to keep our spirits up on this beautiful day here in Toronto. And I'm sure it's a beautiful day wherever you are in the world. This is Soul Expressions. You know what? We're keeping it rare groove. We're keeping it soulful. Let's go to sounds. Michelle Brown.
Hellhole where used to be. If I talk a little silly and I act out of place, it's because I'm not used to being treated this way. Yeah.
After a night like this,
I don't wanna go back home. I don't wanna.
After a night like this,
a sweet night like this, don't send me back home. Your red couch and soft music and dim lights above setting, and ooh, I'm in the mood for love. There is no in between. You see, I'm yours from the start. There is a flame in your kisses.
Sounds of Miss Shirley Brown. To the sounds, Miss Chloe Martin.
Oh, how you changed my whole life, baby. Baby, 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 baby.
It has come.
The Soul Expressions Show.
Thank you.
Shouts out to everyone that's locked on inside the Facebook Live chat room.
He kissed my hands, he kissed my lips, he kissed my arms, he kissed my
sounds of Miss Chloe Martin. Track entirely has come to my attention.
I saw the lightning, heaven and down.
I never felt the world
move. So like I said earlier, woke up this morning to the shocking news that after the news I got earlier this week, like the shocking news that Miss Betty Wright had passed away. You know, fantastic artist, brilliant artist, wonderful voice, wonderful tone. You know, I had the privilege of seeing her a couple of times in her shows and absolutely superb. So we're going to do a dedication to Miss Betty Wright, some of my favourite songs she did. Some down tempo, some up tempo. We're going to do Clean Up Woman, without a doubt. It's going to be in there, but play some stuff that you probably may not have heard and may not be familiar with as well. So we're going to go into our Betty Wright tribute, RIP Betty Wright, express her condolences to her family. Let's go.
A lot of my friends say you're using me.
Miss Betty Wright.
Pure love.
This next track she did with one of the Jacksons, actually, Mr. Marlon Jackson. This is Marlon Jackson, Betty Wright, track entitled I Promise You.
Your hand, I'll understand. hand in here. I'm waiting for you to arrive, my dear. I want you here, right by my side. And I will, girl, I treat you nice all my life. Dream.
Betty Wright, Marlon Jackson.
That I will love you, I promise you.
Big shouts out to Lucia D, my son Jordan, Emma Enser, Kiara Leah, Greg Stokes, Christopher George, Gabrielle.
Please promise me that you will be me. I promise you.
Massive shouts out to Karen.
That I will love you. I promise you.
Big shout out to Tanzin.
Oh, babe, I promise you that I will love you. Please promise me that you will need me. I promise you that I will love you. I promise you.
Our special tribute to the late, great Betty Wright. This next track comes from her Sevens album, which I absolutely love. This one's called Pain.
Love is a four-letter word that we're all familiar with. But there's a four-letter word that I know all too well.
The internet's number one.
Pain, pain, pain. This is only the beginning. So bad. For little does she know, little does she know that it's only her beginning of
shouts out to Del Williams.
He's been the star of the show, but the curtain's down now, not to rise anymore. And little does he know, little does he know that it's only beginning of pain. Little boy, only winnings are said I ain't got no more, no more, no.
doing some long, hard thinking recently about what really causes breakups. You ever notice how fast a person tries to pretend he's gotten over losing his woman, or a woman over losing her man? I don't even like instant coffee, so instant love definitely will not do, honey. I mean, common sense ought to tell you that when you're already down on the ground, you can't pick up nothing but dirt. At least wait until you get up on your feet so you can reach for a star. And you ever notice how your supposed-to-be buddies help you out of your relationship? Man, if that had been me, I'd have been gone. I wouldn't take no mess off no woman. I ain't cooking, I ain't cleaning up. It's woman's work. Yeah, I bet if you just tip up on them sometime unexpectedly, you catch that same big mouth man changing diapers and doing anything else he can find for his little hands to do. You see, some men have better sense than others. They save the baby's back for the real deal, you know what I mean? And maybe you just ought to just pack up your few little clothes you got, get your little act together, try to call a woman up, see if she'll take you back. And try to go home back home, you know, that is if you still can. Little do they know, little do they know, it's only the beginning of
sounds with Betty Wright.
Pain.
And pain.
If you keep on living, you're gonna feel the pain. I know you feel.
And like any good song, there's a sequel.
Well, I couldn't resist the urge to tell you the end of my story. For all of those who wanted to know, was there life after the pain? After the pain, you come. And I welcome you. You're a glad sight to see. And after the rain and all that I have been through, still can't explain how
shouts out to Q.
Not sure did.
Over in the UK, what's going on, brother?
Back again.
Hope you're good, my friend.
It's a woman's prerogative to change her mind, isn't it? Well, we do it all the time.
Don't Miss Betty Wright.
You probably done
R.I.P.
thing too. It's just
the sequel.
Know me, and I don't know you.
After the pain.
You know one thing time has taught me, that having a piece of man is better than having no man at all. So I'm gonna just take what I got and work with it. You understand what I mean? And don't you remember thinking back just a few years when people used to try to help you stay together? They find out you're on the verge of breaking up. They used to cook up a little food and throw a little party and whisper things, and you get like, don't blame Mr. Charlie. Mr. Charlie is just a man, and he's doing the best he can. I heard him say, don't blame Mr. Charlie. Mr. Charlie is just a man, and he's doing the best he can. That's why I still through with love, but there's a God
Soul Expressions Show with DJ Sessions.
So you're tuned in to iLive Radio, DJ Sessions right here on the ones and twos for the Soul Expressions Show each and every Sunday right here on the internet, on Facebook Live, wherever else we're streaming. We're doing our Betty Wright tribute. So we had The Pain After The Pain. Let's do something that rhymes with it. Let's do this one. Sounds a bit right, and make me love the rain. Get beaten up. Shouts out to Auntie Shivy. Didn't see you in the chat room, did I?
I'm coming down. Say,
before you got your E and your brand new B and your exclusive three, I was your baby, I was your ride or die, and it's your one supply and everything you need. There was never room for either to assume you would be leaving, but now that you're brand new, we're getting on through. It's something to take with you. I was your baby, 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 baby.
Sounds Miss Betty Wright. I miss Angie Stone. Legends, one track. Track a title, Baby, Angie Stone and Betty Wright. A couple more from the Betty Wright selection. I'm deliberately not going to play one of them because that's going to get me banned off of Facebook Live, and I don't really want to interrupt the stream and bring everybody back on. So I'm not going to play that track. So you're not going to get Clean Up Woman. Everybody else is doing Clean Up Woman. You're not going to get that from me. However, you will get some of this, and this one goes out to all the Rare Groove connoisseurs. Take it from the Explosion Part 1 album, Betty Wright, and Smother Me With Your Love.
Some women don't like a whole lot of loving. Some women don't like a whole lot of love. But if it's all the same with you, you can love me as long and as hard as you want to. Smother me with your love right now, baby.
Big shout out to Georgia, all the way out there in Calgary. Big shouts out to the Rum Ambassador, Mr. Ian Burrell. What's going on, my friend? Rare Groove Classic. Let's give you another one that was big in the house parties out in the UK. This is our Betty Wright tribute. Taken from the Sevens LP. This is Share My Love. Big shout out to Jules, no matter how you Fox, Oz G, and the whole of the music collective over in the UK.
Share.
Looked like Facebook gave up the ghost. That was fun. Wonder what I played that it didn't like, as always. All right, going to move on with more good music. Let's move on to another Betty Wright classic out of the rare groove scene in the UK. Let's do this.
Could you possibly rewind and come again?
Sounds to Miss Betty Wright. I like your loving. We'll play one more from the Betty Wright selection. This one, what can I tell you, I'm gonna say? Absolutely massive track, this next one here. To all those people that was in dances back in the day when this used to come on, just from the intro, you knew what was about to go down. Sounds of Miss Betty Wright, Keep Love New.
Yeah.
Big shouts out to Farmer.
Hang on in there and when
what's going on, my friend?
Get rough, and it seems
I like Toronto.
Just ain't enough. Just remember God.
Big shouts out to David Compass.
Ooh, he'll shine his light and blessings upon you. Ooh, then our love could stay new and we would too.
Big shouts out to Andrew Charles, Rodney Reed, Mr. Patrick O'Morris, Cousin Sim. So in about 15 minutes, as I said earlier in my show, we're going to do a video tribute to my boy Ty, who passed away earlier this week from complications from COVID. Like I said, it was devastating for the community at large. Anyone that knows Ty was very much knew that he was into the whole community spirit thing, and he did a bunch of events, and he's a UK hip-hop legend. I won't say a rap legend, because you'll see in this video that we're going to play that there's a distinction between rap and hip-hop for him. But for him, hip-hop was a culture, and he kept his hands in that culture and kept everybody together. After the heyday of UK rap, right through, he represented, and it's been such a an amazing outpouring of tributes from people I didn't even know that Ty rocked with. You know what I mean? Like The Roots and Talib Kweli and all those people have done shout outs, tributes. Idris did a tribute to him. Omar did a tribute to him. Like it's been an amazing thing to watch. So I didn't want to do a musical tribute because everyone's doing those. We're actually going to do a video tribute of an interview he did with Shaq D, which will be broadcasting live on the Facebook live stream. You'll only be able to hear the audio on the radio stream. But if you're on Facebook Live and check out the J iLive site, in about 15 minutes, we're gonna go live to that video. All right. Shout out to Shaq D for hooking it up for me. But in the meantime, between time, let's give him some more good soul music.
Say, man.
Everything's.
Check it out, brother. Where's that?
Give me some. Hey,
that
just hanging.
Right on. Talk at you. Hey,
man. I'm going to give it some. Yeah. Barry White.
Are you from the island, too?
Ghetto Leto. Mr. Barry White and Ghetto Leto.
Well, hi, Zay.
Just fine, and you?
It's been a long time, no see.
I seem to have recognized me since I lost weight.
You know, the last time I saw you, you were trying to give me that big
ring. That's my intention.
Oh, brother, B.
Try it now, baby. What it is?
Got it.
So up next, I want to give you one of Ty's favorite groups. We talked about this. We had a big conversation about this group. They're a group called Rasputin Stash. There was an album that came out, Devil Made Me Do It. And, you know, we talked about different things you sample from that, etc. This one here is a Rasputin Stash track that never got released, but it's a cover of Lattimore's Sweet Vibrations. Check it out.
Never know.
The Soul Expressions Show with DJ Session.
Massive shouts out to Shat D. Big shouts out to Freddy Freezer Lopez. Big shouts out to Nikki. Like I said, one of Ty's favorite groups, Rasputin Stash. This is a Sweet Vibration. Go digging in the crates. Sounds of Nike's creation and mellow music.
We make them a new juices flowing from me to you. Your luscious kisses, girl, I love you. I feel sweet melodies with each move we make, and perfect time with every step we take, yeah.
The ninth creation and mellow music. If you're going to pick that up on a seven, it will cost you a pretty penny. And trust me when I say a pretty penny, a pretty penny. All right, another one for the Digging in the Crates crew. This one goes out to Auntie Shivy and Q. See if you remember this one here. Sounds of O'Connor and Too Sweet to Lose. Sounds of O'Connor,
no chance, this romance is,
and Too Sweet to Lose.
Hey, hey, hey. Too sweet to lose, can't take no chance, this romance is, hey, hey, hey.
Yeah, hey. 12 minutes past the hour of four. Right here in Toronto, 12 minutes past wherever it is in the world you are. This is Soul Expressions on iLive Radio and streaming on Facebook Live. Let's give you some more tune. As we keep digging.
Let's go be joy.
Jerlene and friends. Enjoy trip. Squeezing one more before we switch over to the Thai tribute interview with Shat D on My Soul from 5 years ago. This one here, originally done by the OJs, covered by this artist Pandela Kelly. Once again, get it on the 7, you're paying some money. So we're gonna do a short, what's short, about 30 minute tribute to my boy Ty, who sadly passed away from COVID related issues earlier this week. A very, very special friend to me for many, many, many years. We have stories that go way back to my dancing days that I don't talk about. And you know, he did something really cool. Since I've been in Canada, he kind of took my son under his wing, and at his No Long Ting event, and anyone that's been to Brixton and been to No Long Ting, you know what that's about. Pure community, pure vibes. Introduced my son to a bunch of people that me and his mum used to dance with. I used to DJ, be out in the scene, and some of them haven't seen the twins for over 20 years, so it's giving my son some of our history. Showing that we were a real thing back then, a real community. And Ty really, really fought to hold on to that. So I'm gonna play this song as a tribute to him. This is his song. This sums him up. He was Brixton. This is Brixton Baby, and straight after this, we'll be going into the interview.
Safe to gaze, cause some people had their ways. Reggae music was the heartbeat. Loud music hit the car beat. Chauffeur driven angels in their pushchairs. Head ties, headscarf, different footwear. Blue jeans is the uniform. Pretty girls walking round like unicorns. Unaware of their beauty. Getting judged by their chest or the size of their booty. We are many colors, cultures and others. We don't all mix, but we blend with each other in this funny little matrix we call home, where you learn to really watch your tone or guard your phone. The relationship with Popo is so-so. Go help you with your cocoa, it's loco. Struggling gracefully in a place far from make-believe. Hair braids and weed, maybe it's Maybelline. Hard nights for the days between. There is a sunshine, Bill Withers, in the faces of those still with us. Take away plus destiny delivers. Here today, gone tomorrow, many rivers. Folks cutting coconuts in the summer. Watch your back.
Just want to say,
Mike, do a runner.
A happy Mother's Day to all the new moms.
Might catch a black
that's here in, you know, Happy Mother's Day over here in Canada, in the US.
And sizes, wearing intricate but great disguises. Well aware of how great,
including my daughter.
Watch yourself,
love ya.
Play surprises.
I wanted to get Ty down here for quite a few weeks now. I don't write questions down. We're just going to have a conversation and find out who Ty is, turn it off, and what he's up to at the moment. So, yeah, Ty, welcome to My Soul TV.
Shaq, thank you for having me. It's a pleasure. Second time I've been here, but this is the first time I've actually been to My Soul TV. Okay. It's all big and bashy over here. It's an honour to be on this station to be on this show and just to basically support this kind of network. I feel like there's changes in the UK music industry, and this is one of the solutions.
Okay. So, I like where people always phrase this question, but if I landed on Earth today as an alien and I met you and I said, you said to me, you're Thai, what do you stand for?
I stand for good music. I stand for good energy. I definitely am a champion of my people's struggle, particularly on this particular planet. So if an alien's coming in wondering what's going on, and I say my people, I said there is different peoples, there are different groups, and unfortunately that's how history has let it be. So I definitely am up for raising up the profile and the esteem of black people and widening black and white understanding of each other, definitely.
Yeah, I see that a lot by some of the stuff that you will post on your Facebook thread. And it can be anything to do with black history, or recently I saw some children in Africa, and you asked the question, does anybody know where this is? Because you wanted to find out, and I looked at the dance, and I was just like, wow. And you could see these people didn't really have anything,
but they had everything.
Yes, yeah. When they were dancing, you could see that they were happy.
Yeah, they were happier than you see children here happy.
Yeah.
I think I want to just widen this thing. Like for me, what I do with Facebook is I post or repost things that I see in my thread, because I have a wide variant of friends, and it's really about getting people to ask questions. So it's not just about black history or black's problems. It's really about me and you versus the machine and looking at particular things. So if there are particular scandals, we'll look at it. Because at the moment, as far as I can see, us growing up, we've been kind of subjected to just being an audience and not having a voice. You know, if something happens, if a plane crashes, we just got to listen to the information. We can't talk about it and be heard. And I really want to use Facebook as an opportunity for people to kind of speak about certain things, get things off their chest. And also what I've realized is rally people into action, because, you know, talking is cool. But it's good to actually rally people into action and get them to actually speak on things and then actually force certain things to happen, whether it's petitions or marches or anything that's really about getting people to not just sit in a house and sip a cup of tea, but actually say something.
Yeah.
Because when you speak, you educate or you enlighten and illuminate any situation with information only you can give to the table. So it's always we've been dumbed down to think that we can't contribute towards each other's learning, and we can. So I use Facebook to do that.
Yeah, because I've seen it recently with the with the disappearance or kidnapping of the girls in Nigeria.
Mm.
So I saw how you
mobilized
people, and yeah. there was a petition.
There's a protest. Yeah. There's a couple of protests. There's three protests outside the Nigerian embassy in Charing Cross, and loads of stuff. I mean, I didn't organize all of that. It was just I just helped mobilize my circle of people or my net of people who have nets of their own. Mm. And we just took it to the bridge. Like I was really annoyed at the idea that, 63 girls could go missing and be kidnapped and it not be an issue. Whereas, and I knew that if we lived in the UK and 63 girls went missing from the UK, the world would stop. The world would literally...
I could say to you, one girl, if it's the UK. I'm not going to mention any names, but every year, the same girl
That's kind of expected of the UK. We kind of, as you grow up in the UK, you realise that if you don't realise it, you don't realise it. But if you do realise it, you realise that the news centralises on certain things. So when an English person goes missing in a country, it's important. You know, all of these sort of things. And I think these things are so subtle that sometimes you start to actually view yourself as not as important. And that's the reason why I raise issues on Facebook, because I feel like there's a lot of unprogramming that needs to happen.
Okay.
And musically, I try not to, because a lot of people assume that, oh, because of what you do here, this is what you do in your music. It's like, no, Music is an art.
Yeah.
And as much as it's about informing people, educating people, I'm really of the mindset that when it comes to music, you have to do what you feel and not expect to dictate emotions to people.
Yeah, I say that, but listening to your music, you don't do crap music.
No.
Should I say, your music does inform, and there is normally a message. Not in every single track will I say that there's a message, but it's not about Mitch's and goes.
Nice.
Yeah.
Nice. I like that.
Daytime TV. But yeah, it's, you know, I can't remember ever listening to one of your or tracks and there's been, you know, profanity or anything like that. So there's stuff that you clearly, as far as I can say, stay away from.
Yeah, I think I have an intention. Mm-hmm. My intention is to make music that I'll be proud of, that I can sit with my children and say, look, this is what your daddy did. This is what actually made you actually appear on this planet, sucker. This is what made it, this is what made it possible. Here's what paid for that pram.
Yeah.
And I was raised in a environment where because my parents left Nigeria and came here, they raised us in a house to really understand legacy and to understand that we are the continuation of a tree, not the beginning of a tree. Mm-hmm. And so for me, in regards to culture, in regards to music, in regards to our stories, when I started listening to hip hop and started to have an effect in Europe and in the States and over here in the underground circuits, not in the mainstream. So people are like, oh, you didn't sell no records. And no, you don't always have to sell records to do these things. When I started doing that, what I started realizing is that hip-hop music, the actual intention of the hip-hop music and the energy and the skill of itself is one of the only musics that actually brings together all peoples of all walks of life, of all different backgrounds. You can get them all in the same room. In a way that you can't do that with it. Rock music does it to a certain degree, but then...
You think reggae does it?
Here's what I'm saying. Mm. Rock music does it to a certain degree, but when you look at it, most of the people that are listening to rock music have to kind of conform to kind of a rock sensibility, whether it's, you know, I mean, you know, there's a conformation. Whereas in reggae music does it to a certain degree, but there isn't a conformation in that respect. With hip-hop, there isn't a you don't have to conform. You can still be dress how you dress. Mm-hmm. You can still look how you look, but if you like, you know, you see videos of people dancing that have all walks of backgrounds, and there's something about it, and something about the culture, not the music. I'm not talking about, I'm not trying to suggest that Snoop Dogg is the soundtrack of everybody's life. I'm saying that the culture, the actual ability to be interested in turntables, to be interested in who made this record, who sampled this record and made it this record, interest in... The joy that you can see in children when they get to express and dance and do a few moves and, you know, do this stuff and break, you know, when you see kids break dancing, there's nothing like it. Mm-hmm. To me, that is all encompassed in the energy of what a hip-hop aesthetic seems to do. It's one nation under a groove, for real.
Yeah.
And coming out of the house of growing up in a particular legacy and then being... allowed to be part of this legacy and then to be allowed to be part of kind of the leading charge in the UK of as far as hip-hop artists that actually affect and not just make records or have fans but actually contribute via events, contribute via, you know, schools and teachings and all those sort of things. I feel blessed.
Yeah.
I feel responsible. I don't consider the younger generation separate from myself, or I'm not trying to be a kid forever, I'm just saying I don't divorce them from being under my care, if that makes sense. Like, and that's when you say to me there's a message or you don't do certain things, I would say you would expect me not to do certain things if you left your kids with me.
Yes. Yeah.
You would expect me, you'd expect if a bus was coming down the road and your kid was in the road, you'd expect me to pull her off the road. Mm-hmm. You know, you'd slap me if I didn't. But I'm just saying, in regards to music, it's the same. I feel like, you know, we have a responsibility to make people have fun, to make people stay alive. And also, the most important thing for me is there's a relationship between music and culture in regards to people of all backgrounds, of all different denominations, have some sort of music wherever they go that they connect with. Eskimos, I'm sure they've got a music that they like, mm-hmm. or a sound
It's funny to say that, because I was watching Jazzy Jeff thing on YouTube last week, and he said that he doesn't ever feel that we would exist in a place where there's no music.
Right, exactly. Yeah. So, in regards to, if you look at, hip-hop is the reason why us lot are in the room right now. As in, we would maybe be meeting talking about something else. And reggae, you know, is a possible thing, but I don't think the wide net of scope of people and activities has ever, nothing's ever challenged the and done as much in regards to what hip hop is doing. Because it's so, because you mentioned reggae, I'll go back between the two. What I'm trying to say is, there's so many levels of participation in hip hop music.
Yeah, you've got the graffiti, the dancing, the music, actual music, you've turntables, the rapper. Yeah,
then you've got the production.
Yeah.
Then you've got the fascination with the breaks. Yeah. Then you've got, you know, then you've got the collection of music. It just goes on and on. So to me, it's actually, they're all part of each other. Like, it's separating them is by genre doesn't even make sense, because if you listen, if you like good music, yes, you'll have some reggae.
I'll ask you a question actually, mm-hmm, which I like to ask a lot of people. What's the difference between rap and hip hop?
Oh, it's simple. Simple. You ready for this?
Yep.
Do I look at the camera when I do this?
You can.
All right. So, the difference between rap and hip-hop is simple. Let me put it in a metaphor for you. Rap is a room. Hip-hop is a house. Which one would you rather rent?
Ooh.
So let me put it to you like this. Rap is the room. Hip-hop is the house. As in, rap is a room in the house of hip-hop. Hip-hop is not a room in the house of rap. So when people look at it and, oh, but, you know, but this is hip-hop, this is rap. No. Hip-hop is the culture. Hip-hop is understanding the music. Hip-hop is sitting on the tube and looking at someone when they come on, looking at the jeans they're wearing and realising, oh, they probably like a little bit of hip-hop. Or looking at their clothes and being like, oh. Or, you know, it's a connection, it's a cultural calling card of all backgrounds. That, like, you know, you might see someone wear a baseball cap a certain way and you're like, you're not adverse to a little Snoop Dogg, are you? You know what I mean? That's, whereas in rap is just pretty much the songs on radio, whether you like the artist or not, and whether you're fascinated with them and whether you chant, you know, certain styles of music or you like certain things, that's cool. But hip hop is the vibration. Hip hop is traveling airport to airport to airport to airport and seeing that kids of all different backgrounds. I've been to Gaza. I've been to Israel and Gaza and done hip hop workshops, pumped hip hop, and actually seen Israeli and children, Palestinian children, dancing together. I've been a part of things like that, and hip hop can do that. Mm-hmm. Reggae can't, not really.
I'm playing,
Michelle. So that's the difference. I don't know if I extended it too much, but
I was not expecting that answer. But yeah, I just thought it's a question I like to ask different people.
Mm.
And you've given me a completely different spin on it. I'm going to be using it. There's only one.
Room
in the house.
Yeah, it's a qualifier. Honest, like, a lot of people that speak on it will have different interpretations. But then I would say myself and other people are probably overqualified in regards to answering that, because we are living testaments of this particular thing. And we, you know, there's no Saturday job with Ty. This is what I do.
Okay.
So when you're asking me to a free collaboration, pay up. No blame. Okay, moving.
Right, tell me about your albums. How many you've done? Where you're at the moment? Give me that spiel.
Okay, so albums at the moment, I think we're at four. I think we've done four. So there was Awkward, then there was Upwards, which was this album, which was a classic. A lot of people went crazy
on that one. What's happened? Anyway, sorry.
Yeah, it was 10 years ago. So, 10 years ago. Yeah, I'm losing hair now. Then there was the Closer album, and then there was a Special Kind of Full album, which was the last full album I did, which came out in 2010. I brought out an EP last year called Kick, Snare and Idea, which was received really well, and we did vinyl for that as well. I didn't bring vinyl with me today because I didn't want to cycle with it.
Why did you do vinyl?
I did vinyl because my belief is vinyl and record is a sacred testament and vehicle for hip hop culture that is way beyond fashion and trends. So, you know, things change, mini disc, CD, DAT, tape, mini DV, all. But I think the record, the actual physical thing, it's an artifact. It's an actual real, and I think because I've been raised to actually understand and appreciate legacy and not just be like, oh, throw that away. Oh, throw that away. Oh, throw that away. You know, we've been taught to appreciate these things. It's like we had to make the record and make sure that people had, you know, you can put it in a window, you can put it on a wall, you can do whatever you want.
What a lot of people have done, it's after art. They bought it, put it up, take pictures.
It's art.
Post it back to you.
Yeah, that was hilarious. Yeah. But it's art, you know, like, I'm really, there is a...
I'm going to admit something here, I still haven't got my copies.
That's cool.
It's good thing you didn't say. How many parts is it now?
It's 3 parts, it's cool, but we can sort that out. Okay. But, you know, it's a good thing you didn't tell us before we did the interview. There'd be no interview. Moving on. So... Moving on.
It's all love. Love Shack.
Love Shack.
Actually, before he carries on, if you listen to the Love Shack, at the start of the Love Shack, every week, it's this man. The Love Supreme, ladies and gentlemen. It's him. It's him. He starts my show. Anyway, carry on. Vinyl, 3 parts, legacy.
Legacy. So for me, with putting vinyl together and putting it out, there is a denomination with our music, whereas in there's a kind of debasing of the value of making music and of also understanding that hip-hop music is an art form, is a sport. Mm-hmm. So what I've tried to do in my last few releases is make the packaging, to make the music, to make the videos, all kind of visual, artistic interpretations that, you know, anyone that loves the music can turn around and be like, yes, you see, this is why I like this thing. Because this is, you know, rather than do this, you know, 2P record, hey, ha, what's up, huh, bye. It's like I'm spending time. We're looking at it with a magnifying glass, white coat, stroking beards, trying to figure out what to do with that hi-hat. You know, we're paying that attention. And I think there has to be people that still give music that amount of attention. I was having this conversation in the car recently, and we were talking about how music nowadays, you can tell how long people have spent making music. You can tell it in a pop record, you can just tell. Mm-hmm. But then when you go back to like the Beach Boys and you listen to their music, you're like, and then if you watch the DVD, if you watch, go on YouTube and watch the documentaries on the Beach Boys, come on now. Them guys are not playing around.
Did you see the video that Big Ted posted recently with that guy that done a Jason Derulo tune?
Yes.
That just goes feedback to what you said. Because he actually broke, this guy was a bit of a geek-looking guy.
Beautiful.
And he broke down how quickly it would take to make a Jason Derulo record.
Yeah.
And his finished product was actually quite similar to...
Yeah.
What, you know.
Yeah, he took all the elements and just like, this is what you do, this is what you say, mm-hmm. then you say something cheesy, then you say something, and he was quite non-disrespectful mm-hmm. about it.
Yeah.
But I do think that with pop music and with hip-hop music, there is a real lowering of the guard at the moment. And I try, so when people say, oh, you know, you've got a message and blah, blah, I'm like, I'm having fun. Mm-hmm. It's not all heavy, heavy, heavy over here. It's just that, in regards to the appreciation, like, you know, we're appreciating the art form a little bit over here. There is no rush job. There is no 5-minute beat here. Mm-hmm. It's there is no 5-minute rap here. Yeah. It's kind of
I know that for a fact because I was trying to get hold of you for that same jingle at the start of the show, and he just disappeared. And then when he reappeared, I was like, I'm really sorry, I buried myself in the music, and I was like, cool. He's like, I've got something for you though. So I'm like, yeah, well, whatever. What's your email address? Yeah, blah, blah, blah. Check your email address. Play. Wow. So, yeah, I understood. Because I was just expecting, you know, a little.
I'll be honest, I planned to update that. But The thing is, the way that we work, because we work like composers, if I had done that in my home studio, in the proper studio, and because I did it with Deluxe, big up to Deluxe. And we were doing it in the middle of doing vocals for other stuff. Deluxe is a producer, a new co-producer that I work with as well.
Yeah.
And if I'd have done it like with me and Drew, the way we do it, there'd have been instruments in there. There'd have been singing in there. There'd have been stuff going on.
Excited,
so we will revisit that. But coming back to the process,
do
I think.
Do you know I can do beatbox?
Huh?
Did you know I can do beatbox?
Do I know you can do beatbox?
Yes.
Are you qualified to do beatbox in my songs? Slaps! Pew! Can you feel it?
Psh. Okay. Anyway, yeah.
So, I got hit. You got to understand, we go back, we go further back. So this might seem a certain way, but it's not. Cool. You know, he will have me in a headlock afterwards.
So what am I whispering? Anyway, yeah.
Yeah.
Deluxe production. Yeah,
yeah, production. Right. So to me, one of the things that people don't know about what we do is that I take pride in every element. So, you know, like Ben Machenji did the last two covers. He did the Special Kind of Fool cover, which is the cover with the wooden head that was carved from a tree in Brockwell Park and stuff
How
like that.
How long did it take him to do that?
Oh, took him a while. Took him about 2 months. But he's a serious guy. Like Ben Machenji to me is someone that people should be interviewing because like his contribution to art, mm-hmm. to hip hop, to health. He started that. He helped create that little gym, the outside gym that's happening in Brixton right now,
okay.
where a lot of the youth are going to, and there's a movement there now.
Maybe you can put him in contact with me. Definitely, and we can do this.
Definitely. Big up, okay. brother Ben Machenji. So for me, the process of records and making records is something that people are not only becoming a little bit aware of now. I'm a little bit of a lost scientist in that respect, as in everything gets cut off. Like sometimes I don't speak. My mum's vexed with me right now because there's like, oh, I don't get no call. And it's like, well, I'm doing the album. So you can come and see me. But
I'm doing an album right now.
I'm working on the album right now.
Okay.
And when I'm working on the album, but working on an album for me is always splintered in between real life.
Okay.
So, a lot of people would be like, of course, that makes sense. I'm like, no, let me explain. What, you know, obviously, you know, you have to go and brush your teeth and then go to work and then do your music. But what I'm saying is, when I'm working on a record, everything becomes about solving the puzzle. Everything becomes about, right, I've got this particular beat, or I've got this particular idea, I want to chop it a certain way. Like when I did the Carol Thompson record, I have to explain that here, because I got so much support from the station with that record. When I did the record, I chopped the sample up, the Rare Groove record, and I'd been to a Carol Thompson Janet Kay concert, and I was just blown away. And I met her son. We got to Annie and. I wanted a CD, I got a CD signed, and I just wanted to keep in contact. And then when I had that beat, I was like, you know what, I want to get a lover's rock singer, because I'm always about repainting the history. Like, I feel like, you know, this is a music genre where you have to leave bits of gingerbread on the floor mm-hmm. for people to come back to find things.
Okay.
And the UK that I live in, at the moment, is very very political about the term black music.
Okay. Can I interrupt you there for a
minute? Yes.
That gingerbread thing you just said there. Last year, I went to see Ty at a jazz cafe, and probably should slap myself because I didn't really do any research. But when you played the introduction to Cheers, before you played, is it Like You Never?
Mm-hmm.
Like, before you played Like You Never?
Mm.
That was when I worked it out. Before then, I'm listening along to this song, I'm like, yeah. But I didn't know that sample was in there. And when you came out to that, and I was like, hold on a minute, that blew me away. That was a gingerbread moment for me. I was like,
I'm glad that it was, because it's not actually the sample.
Oh, I got it the wrong way?
Yeah.
Thanks.
So. We spliced it together really well. So that was part of the process.
Okay.
So the process was to do a show and for it to be seamless and to have bits here. The gingerbread moment was actually in the show was we're doing a show and we're performing and I'm this black 6 foot tall rapper, quite big, doing what I'm doing, dancing around, having fun. But then all of a sudden we drop a record that all of a sudden everybody in the room has an understanding, has a relationship mm-hmm. with that piece of music.
Mm-hmm.
And that's my way of saying, you know, we're all here, right? We all come from different walks of life, but there's certain things that we have that absolutely resonate mm-hmm. with us.
Yeah.
all of us. And the point of that gingerbread moment was to say, we are all people. We are all music lovers. We all love good, you know, good product. And, you know, we no matter where you were, we all were at different points. One person was sat on the left side of grandma's leg, one person was sat on the right side of uncle's leg, or someone was watching television. We all received the same signal and it registered. Mm-hmm. And that's what that was about. So we have triggers.
It wasn't in there?
No. Nobody knows the record.
Big Ted, my soul, done a good job of making music.
Yeah, we cut it.
Samples in it.
It's the same key as the piano sample.
So not completely stupid.
No.
I sounded like it was in there. I went home and I downloaded it and I was like...
No. But, so the process really for us with the show and with... Well, I'm glad you mentioned that. Is really to have a connection with the audience. It's not just about me doing the records. Mm. We've never approached making music or performing music from the perspective of, I'm now going to do the record that you love. Mm-hmm. It's always about, I'm now going to do the record that you love as an excuse to get close to you and then have some fun. Mm-hmm. Bang! Yeah. And
well, I say, last year, after I left that show, I was absolutely buzzing. I bought my ticket. I wasn't one of these like, yeah, I know him. Sort me out. Bought my ticket, and it was money well spent. It was an absolute honour to be there.
It was a nice thing for us because Jazz Cafe allowed me mm-hmm. To actually program my whole show how I want. So most times with promoters, what they do is they book you into a show, and then they tell you who's here, who's there. I was like, no, I don't want none of that. If you're booking me, you take it's I'm in control. Mm-hmm. As in, I'm going to tell you every single person, down to the lighting, down to which engineer I want, down to who I want supporting, who I want sub-supporting, who I want DJing. I don't want any, nothing. No strangers. You know where I learned that from? Damian Marley. The Damian Marley Nas concert. Okay. They take control. Their concert is ridiculous because they just buy the venue. Mm-hmm. They're not hired, they're not booked by the venue. They just buy the venue for the day.
Okay.
And then they, this is what it's going to be. We're going to fill out this place. We're going to have our stuff. These are the support acts. This is what it is. And, you know, and I love that control. And I think it's important to have that level of control here in music.
You can do that again?
Yeah, we're going to do more. We're going to do more events. I mean, people are screaming for us to be much more active in the event side of things because there's a particular calm or a particular trust that the audience have in my DJs, in Big Ted, in DJ Business, in myself, in my unit, in Breeze, in different. You know, there's a particular warmth. It's not a soppy. It's not a teddy bear hip hop show. It's just more about people feel like, oh, I'm gonna have a good time. I'm not going to fight with somebody today. Mm. I'm just going to have fun, and I think that's we really are trying to push that element. It needs to be that. It can't. People, the music industry is too quick to tether a violent angle to our culture. And
you were just about to say something about the term.
I was going to go there. You did cut me off.
We got back then.
And it's cool.
I was sitting there and thinking, I need to get back to what he was saying. What was he saying?
It's cool. Let's start fresh. In this country, we are fighting a really subtle war that everybody needs to pitch in. At the moment, people have made it seem like, oh, if you've got a problem and it's the black music thing, then it's your problem. If you're black, it's your problem. No, it's everybody's problem. Let me explain. We all love this music, right? We love it. We dance to it. It's something infectious about it. In fact, we all love different types of music, right? You know, if you put on, what's his name, the guy that died, Nirvana. You put the Nirvana record on, I dare you to find someone that's going to stand still to that record. It's just not going to happen. Yeah. So we all love different things. The problem we have is, in the UK, the term black music has become a thing where people are saying, well, it needs to be urban, it needs to be something else, blah, blah, blah. And we accepted it at first. Everybody was like, oh, okay, blah, blah, there's a problem here. Problem is this. Problem is threefold. Might be morefold, but I'm going to go three because it sounds good. One, my mum is not urban. My son is not urban. I'm not urban. But the music I bring forth to the table is coming from a black perspective. Mm-hmm. And Stevie Wonder was coming from a black perspective. He made music that was for everybody to enjoy, but it came from his background,
okay,
right? So to turn around the music term now and to soften it up and say, oh, but it feels a certain way is ungrateful to what the background is.
Yeah.
Two, a poppadom is a poppadom. Curry is curry. Nobody's changing the title of the food because other people eat it. Nobody's doing that. Flamenco, the dance, people that dance flamenco are all different backgrounds. We're not changing the terminology to make everybody feel welcome. But for some reason, we're slapping black people in the face and saying, yeah, we like your music, but you can't call it black. I feel uncomfortable if it's called black. This is the third point I'm going to make now. The real issue should be, no, you need to explain why you feel uncomfortable about liking something that's called black music. You need to explain it. I don't need to change it. You need to explain that. Yeah, shame.
What is it? Say it again, just in case.
Timemusic.co.uk. Mm-hmm. The t-shirt is from Like You Never. This is a t-shirt that was specially made by AOH in New York, in America. And it's available on my website, which I will get those details as well.
Okay.
And I'm working on the album and doing shows. So we're doing a few festivals and traveling, going to different countries and doing certain things. That's what we always do. Okay. And it just keeps rolling. So keep an ear out, join the mailing list, which will give you the links for that. And absolutely join the mailing list. Then you'll get all of the up-to-date information.
Okay. Thank you very much for finally coming down and meeting me. Ty, on My Soul TV. Thank you very much.
Wow.
So you can get that whole interview over on YouTube. Search for My Soul Ty and Shat D. R.I.P. my friend. I hate to hate, but find myself hating. But it can't participate. Ty, living legend. My level hair, rebel hair. On some other gear, ever so talwa. Tough back lover, squirting out the blubber. Keeping it warm up. Up next, quiet. Top of the hour, Lucia D. Who's fighting for folks, fighting to be the nicest. Black gold. With Honey Drop. This has been DJ Sessions. I guess you bring to rappers. One of very special soul expressions. Bling, please refreeze the world. Check the replay on the podcast. I'm not just a break the scene. Or on Spotify. But I'm in this bubble like I'm daily. You can check the multiple videos. Troubled like a baby screaming. On Facebook where they go cut us off. And every day we scheming. Oh, you want more? You just wiggle your hips now. So you want more? Come girl, just give me a kiss now. So good night, good afternoon, God bless. Happy Mother's Day.
Place called Hello Endio, and you know where that is. Life wasn't just a friendly game of bait.
Check me out later on tonight, 9 o'clock.
There's a life messing with the wrong.
We come back and do a tribute to Andre Harrell and Uptown Records.
6 miles all
on Facebook Live. Got to be great. Or on iLive Radio.
But see if your troubles can't hold you down. I really can't believe how far we've come. Remember when this was a brand new sound? I got to pay respect to my man James Brown. Gonna make you proud even though we're low ground. Someone in my head won't let me fail. Even though the life I've seen is harsh. Even though the air we breathe is stale. Call it what you want, but they call me world class, my friend.
This could be
to my folks, could have been a cockroach thinking thinking that I really own a postcode. Hey, who would have thought a Brixton boy would travel the globe and put the devil in a chokehold? Perseverance is the key, but it ain't free. Rock for a while, sweat for a fee. Doesn't really matter what you think about them. Doesn't really matter what you think about me. Cause I'm destined to do great things. I'm a leader, so I won't follow when I make things hot. Best beware where I live isn't fair. Turn your back, it's like Goldilocks and the Three Bears. And the moral isn't clear, cause tomorrow isn't here. Shall I put a little bug up in your ear? We are the future, so either let us in the door or get out of my chair.
This could be, boy, the start of something big.
Something.
You can get me, boy, now, if you did.
Something big.
Take time to learn my every want and need. I promise I'll be everything a woman's expected to be. Now,
so take
the lead.
Something big.
I had a dream and I followed it. Along the way I learned sometimes you have to swallow it due to politics, but I can't be deterred. Hold it down, watch another dream emerge. Failures for the birds, plus I don't mind winning. Don't mind chilling, don't mind grinning teeth with fine women. Depending on the beat, I really don't mind killing. Depending on the street to really stop the blood spilling in the